までの味噌全部そんな感じ。ああの日のこと思えば真っ黒焦げ痛みで目が冴える。怖いから愛へ愛されて愛まで念願切りなし。呪われた僕らは遠い子になって。
Oh my god, we're live. Hello, good morning. Welcome back to Hippo Cup 7, where it is now a best of one. We've got more matches in the round of 16. We've got Hippo Cup what versus Le Grand Balmer. We've got me. We've got Dio. What's going on? How's it going? Good morning.
Hey man, I woke up before my alarm on 6 hours of sleep. Stayed awake anyway. Made breakfast. Ate it during a 3-digit World Cup match. My toaster was broken. It somehow unbroke itself while I was trying to make toast this morning. There's also another 1.5 feet of snow on the ground that I just snowblowed yesterday off my driveway and shoveled off of my back patio so my dogs can go outside, and so I have to do that today also. So you could say it's a good day. Got some exercise lined up. I got some breakfast. I got some coffee. I'm doing well.
We love breakfast and coffee. Honestly, I am working on my first cup of coffee. I was in bed this morning longer than I can't remember the last time I was able to like be in bed until like 10:45 in the morning. But here we are.
Nice.
Yeah. Well, it's because I actually found people to commentate the 14:30 UTC match, so I didn't have to. It was pretty nice. And now we get some Osu. We get Lystia, Ninerik, Raikou, Fiery Eternum, Lucrece, Fragrance of Page. Joined by Ethan Trix and Belladonna, which are kind of like they're just on the team somehow. Those two names don't fit in with the rest of this roster, I feel. They're against Semi, Magnetic Gamer, Chillington 15, which is I can never remember Manny Vat, Polly, Hifkill, Invoker, Hanori, Suzuha, and Z9A. Hippo Cup teams. These are like very Hippo Cup teams.
These are very Hippo Cup teams, yeah. This is like the we have a full European team plus Invoker and a just complete mixed bag, like three Americans. Fiery Rage is on a team with Fragrance of Page and four Europeans. Like, is this just the most 15 UTC Hippo Cup team ever, or what?
I remember I was talking to Lystia about this team and like their scheduling, because obviously, you know, you've got -8 and +9 on the same team.
With Europeans, of course.
Yeah, with the Europeans. And so Lystia went in and asked, you know, Fragrance of Page, and like they had a quick crisis of when they'd be able to play, but apparently Fragrance of Page is your standard Korean who can play, you know, 16, 17 UTC.
All right, 4 in the
like,
morning.
Whatever,
yeah,
this is fine. So I guess it's all good. I believe also, as far as Fiery Rage goes, I think he was in LFT. I want to say he was in LFT in this tournament, so he just got picked up.
I feel like people shit on Fiery Rage too much, because, like, yes. How is the guy with the most World Cup badges ever in LFT in an open rank tournament? Like, what?
I have been on that train for a long time. Fiery gets the most undue amount of disrespect as a tournament player
ever. Like, I don't even know. Yeah.
It makes no sense to me. Dude always shows up, like, his floor is super high. His ceiling might not be quite as high as, you know, the top guys. Obviously, he doesn't have the ceiling of, like, a Malachevsky or an Emrek, but not many people do. But his floor is so high, like, why would you not want him on your team if he's available? I don't get it.
Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, Nomad 1, Freemod 2 bans from Hippo Cup what? DT4 ban from Le Grand Balmer.
Yeah, so...
And I have instantly forgotten all of the bands
I have listed,
so you can
look.
Talk about those.
Yeah, so that's that's 1/2, 1/2, 0.5. I'm not really sure.
That song's good. I'm sad that's banned, actually.
Yeah, the song is really nice. Freemod 2 is Mechadesu, so that's like the low AR, small circles Freemod. DT4 is Traumeray TV size, so that's just like fast break. It's like 280-something BPM. And then last ban... TBD.
Last ban TBD. I don't see that in the pool, but I'll trust you on that.
Shut up. Get out of here. You already made the worst joke of the day. All right, now here we go. It's Freemod 3 last ban. So that's double speed. It's actually like a double speed ban, right? The DT4 is...
I can't even make the joke about that
Freemod,
map anymore.
Freemod
Come on,
3.
Man.
Well, if you look at Freemod 3's Hard Rock star rating, Dio, what jumps out at you, friend?
Of course, you see and see and see and see and see and see it. So
there you go. You got your opportunity.
Thank you.
Opportunity.
I'm happy now.
Yeah. So, well, Grand Baldur just does not want to have to play speed against a team with Ninerik, Raikoho, and I don't really know who else goes in for tapping maps on the team, but when you've got those two, it's a pretty solid start.
Yeah, like Ninerik, Raikoho, Eternum, Lucrece, Fragrance of Page can also play speed. Lysia can also play Page. Some speed.
I did not know Fragrance of Page played speed. I did not have that player pegged in my mind as a guy who would be a speed player, not gonna lie to you.
Am I trolling? I think
I don't know. You may well be right. I don't know a lot about the guy. I've not really seen I don't know that I've seen him in a tournament other until like literally now, right? This and 3WC.
Yeah, I mean, I think like Identity Part 4 Hidden Double Time is maybe a good indicator, you know?
Yeah. Alright, dude does a small amount of tapping, I suppose.
A slight amount.
So Nomad 1, Freemod 2, I don't feel like there's a connection between those two maps. So I don't know what you pick if you ban those. Like, obviously, if you're banning, like, both tapping maps, you're probably going to be picking stuff that's non-raw mechanics.
I mean, I think they just didn't want to play Mechadesu, and,
yeah.
As for the Nomad 1, you're against a team full of, you know, three-digit tournament players, so probably just banning out tournament map alt stuff, I don't know.
It is a DT5 first pick for Grand Balner, DT5 being the low BPM, super, super old DT, right? This is a, like, 2010 or 2011 Kirby Mix, Grid Snap, Linear, old map. We saw Wubblefulf yesterday on this, have a really, really good score. He's had like a one miss right at the very end.
Wubblefulf is playing this tournament?
He is indeed playing this tournament. That map has actually now been picked. That map has now been picked in all four matches, by the way.
When is the last time I saw Wubblefulf in a tournament?
I don't know. I was surprised as well. I saw him on the roster. I thought he probably wouldn't actually play, but as it turns out, he's actually playing. He is on on a team. The Lithlath Love? No. What team is it? Grease Monkey. That is the team he is on. Our streamer is having a little bit of difficulty currently sizing the caster icons on the screen here. I believe in him. I have faith.
He will accomplish.
There we go. Okay, we are now the correct casters. Surely the location will be.
We are slightly cut off on the bottom, but all good.
It's okay. We are Dennis and T1G Fish. I mean, what more needs to be said?
No, that's true.
So
T1G Fish, thoughts on the roster for both of these teams on the first pick?
Well, Fiery, Lucrece, Eternum, Ethan Trix. I mean, Fiery is just like good at these maps, right? Really good at old style, this kind of linear grid snap stuff. Grand Balner, like, Invoker is the ultimate Hippo Cup player. That dude is really, really good at Hippo Cup maps. Semi is, I think, pretty solid all around. Z9 I am a little less familiar with, so I don't really know. And then Hanori probably just kind of feels like a fourth for this roster. I don't know.
ZNIA is the Polish 3WC player, if I'm remembering correctly. Don't quote me, but...
He is, in fact, Austrian, so I will not quote you, in fact, at all on that. Yeah, I am genuinely not familiar with this player. I feel bad saying that, but it is the case.
Yeah.
There's also a Z10A, I believe. It's like a user collab thing.
Yeah.
But in we go, map number one, best of 11 here. First pick from LeGrand Balner, first breaks from Lucrece, Invoker, and then Semi following it up. Hippo Cup, what? Early combo lead in a very short map. This one is like a minute long. This DT pool is really quite quick.
Well, good score lead for now. Another break from Lucrece, though. Semi, Invoker, and Z9A are not on the full combo for LeGrand Balner, so... now, actually, no FCs except for Ethan Trix and Hanori on either side. Slightly more combo. Whoa, there goes Ethan Trix. And now, suddenly, Hanori may be able to carry this map. Invoker also on good combo, but not enough time. And a slightly less than 1 million score lead for Hippo Cup. What? Because this map is, like, 60 seconds long.
Yeah, it's 54 seconds long. You think something's going to happen, and then it can't because it's already over. you just run out of time. That is a, is that an FC with really low ACK? I don't honestly know.
That was an FC from Hanori, I think. Here, I will check the hidden double time no fail.
I'm working on it. Yeah, 373 is max combo. So that was an FC from Hinori with 89 ACK and an A rank. Well, you know, happens.
Happens.
With good ACK, they wouldn't have won that anyway, so I don't think it really matters. I don't think he makes up another million points with good ACK. So, whatever. Freemod 4, first pick from HippoCup. What? We're Omote lovers. This is the satellite diff. Which is the one that was like a tourney map? I don't. Is it top?
Those the yeah map? Yeah. I think it was the Gazimal top diff. Was in OWC this year.
Yeah, yeah.
Satellite special diff is well, you know when maps have just special as the diff name, and then they're like the most overlap hell map you've ever seen in your life. That's this, but you know with streams.
I see. Should be fun.
Yeah.
Digital hypno pooling moment. We just put things in and hope for the best.
I mean, this is a map that could be used in a tournament, but it is very, very tricky. Let's put it that way. I don't think I would call this like memorization, but there's definitely some elements where if you check the editor, you're probably better off than your opponents. So,
and this is a whole bunch of tournament players, so you would like to think you would like to think that they are properly prepared. And so away we will go. It is going to be whoop.
Killington 15 could not join.
Nanivat was trying to join, did not end up joining. He is going now. I believe now we'll it looked like I was just curious. It looked like HippoCup was overmodding. It looked like they had two hiddens and a hard rock. But you have pref mod hidden players on that team, so not the craziest thing. I didn't get a glimpse at LeGrand Balner's mods, so I don't know what they want. Let's see.
Well, we'll see now.
One hidden, one hard rock. Not required, but not a terrible choice, I suppose, on a map that has some reading elements to it.
I think if you have players who can go double hard rock on this, maybe it's better, but I don't know, perfect overlaps on hard rock are also very difficult, so I don't think it's much better than hidden.
We'll see if HippoCup What can get the back up to that breakpoint, consolidate early on. I'm seeing the varied mod choices here on these types of maps. Always cool to see players competent on hidden or hard rock on perfect stacks and overlaps and things like that. Semi, all right. Did he? Oof.
That's, yeah. That's, see, this is what I was talking about with like maybe if you are playing hidden, you check the editor on this map because how?
And there goes Z9A as well. Rough going for LeGrand Balner. HippoCup What was like, we are prepping this map and we are going to know what we're getting ourselves into.
You know, I played a tourney match with Semi at four UTC. We had a four UTC tourney match. And Semi showed up to it, so I don't know how much sleep this guy's got in between.
I'm gonna go with not enough, and there goes Booker and Z9A as well. His eyes are a little tired, perhaps. Just a tad bit. And HippoCup What just had their first break. Break a hoe, everyone, but until then, everyone holding. So, already a healthy lead of 7 million points. Halfway through, this is feeling quite over because there's literally no combo on LeGrand Balner at all. It doesn't even matter that Fiery and Reiko just broke because Ethan Trix and Lysia are grooving.
Yeah, the two hidden players full comboing this is really not what I expected, I'm gonna be honest. Like, yeah. What?
I mean, to be fair, this is like, this is like Lysia's, like something Lysia's really good at, right? Is like hidden reading stuff, so. Ethan Trix, I'm a little less familiar with the extent of his skill set, but clearly this is working out for him. This is, we live in a society where a team can win by 20 million points.
Yeah, I don't know. Ethan Trix is also just a really good reading player, so I'm not super surprised to see him in and taking hidden, but. His map is ostensibly easier on no mod or hard rock than it is on hidden, and somehow the only full combo left in the lobby is on Lysia with hidden.
I don't know. Listia is actually 1v4ing, by the way. Which, strictly, I suppose, less impressive on V2 or on V1 than on V2, but still pretty cool.
And I almost saw a 1v3 in the 3-Dit World Cup match, actually, just now.
Oh my goodness.
V2.
Oh my god, that's messed up. I don't even know which... Oh, the back and forths! Oh, those back and forths!
Alicia's still hitting them!
Alright.
Still going strong!
Alright. Almost there. Almost there! Wow. Nice job, Listia. That's a really good score.
There is one hidden full combo on the leaderboard right now. Listia actually has a hidden Hard Rock 4 miss that is number 2 on the leaderboard. And that is probably the best hidden no-fail score on this map.
Yeah. That would have been rank 3 on the map, based on the accuracy, behind Woey and, you know, Listia again.
Yeah.
So, that Woey score is actually... That's a Hippo Cup score as well, 4 days ago. He's not even playing, but that's a Hippo Cup score. He played that after the pool was released. It's a Hippo
Cup
score.
He knew about this map before Hippo Cup as well. He's suggested it to me to pool before, actually, which is why I know about the map.
But you are not Digital Hypno.
But I am not Digital Hypno, and it was for some other tournament I don't remember at this point. And we wanted to use it as like a hidden reading low AR pick, basically, as a substitute for a low AR map. And it was cool, but I was also like, damn, this seems like an editor map. I don't know about this one, dude.
I love editor maps. When you can just instantly tell who practiced and who didn't.
Yeah.
That's that good stuff. I feel
the 1v4s.
You know, I feel like Hippo Cup, right? You know, it's not a conventional pooling structure, typically. And there are some very... atypical maps you will often see. Therefore, I feel it is generally speaking a good idea to look at the pools in this tournament. I've been seeing this like complaint from people like, oh, when there isn't slot pooling anymore, I can't sight read, so I don't like it. It's like, man, just I don't know.
Just don't sight read.
Just don't sight read. Speaking of not sight read, it's distance snap. Please don't sight read this map.
Please don't sight read this. Yeah, no, I've seen other complaints about the like no slot pooling thing of like, hey, these pools aren't balanced anymore because I get the slots are dead thing, but like, why are there 8 bajillion reading maps in this pool, or why is the entire pool finger control or aim control or stuff like that? I get those complaints.
Yeah,
the not sight reading thing is very funny. Very funny as somebody who spends hours and hours putting the pool together. Maybe practice.
Yeah, you know, to me, it's like, imagine, I don't know, imagine like a golfer showing up to a tournament and going out for the first round without ever having seen the course before. You know?
Yeah.
Like, would you do that? No. I don't know that there's a lot of other direct comparisons that I could make, but that one I think fits pretty well.
Yeah, I don't know. Every time I'm on a new course, I'm just like, okay, what the hell is this course
exactly
doing?
Yeah. Like, is there room over there? I have no idea. If I take my drive out a little right, will there be space? Like, are there perfect overlaps on this green? I don't know.
Yeah. How far does the sand trap go? Does it run all the way around the green? There's a course near me called Northern Dunes that is kind of as you would expect by a course that's called Northern Dunes, just completely full of sand traps. And one of them runs 3/4 of the way around an entire green. And it's like 30 yards wide or something. Also, like it's like they put a lake made of sand around the green.
Island green, except it's sand instead of water.
So you show up to that course and you're playing it for the first time. You're like, what the hell is going on here?
Exactly. Like, it just helps to know what you're getting yourself into. I don't know. Anyway, we've got distance snap. We've got early break from Hinori, and also not really that early because this map is also quite short. It's just a minute and a half, so, you know, it is... goodbye, LeGrand Balder.
Goodbye, LeGrand Balder.
I feel like picking... Why do you pick reading after what just happened on that free mod? Why would you pick a reading map against this team after what just happened? I feel like that was a mistake. I don't know. Like, you're getting triple FC'd on with zero FCs on your own team.
Yeah, I mean, what can you do? Not pick this, I guess. Pick something else.
Wait, Ethan is alting and he has 87 ACK. What a beast. Are they gonna four-way this? That's really funny. They've probably all played this in some tournament or other before.
Oh, Ethan missed it the four again! I think that's a slide to break too. Oh no, it isn't.
Actual miss. It's a C rank.
Oh, they
three-way. Also, Lysia with the A rank. Huge.
Huge.
I overtapped. He got note locked on, actually. He must have gotten note locked on.
Yeah.
That's a shame. All right, so that's 3-0 double break point, but like, why did LeGrand Ballner pick that other than for the funny? I think it was just for the funny.
It might have been for the funny. It was funny.
It was hilarious. I'm here for it.
Yeah. I missed on aim on a 4-star. Yeah, understandable. You know,
that's a mood. As somebody who is very poorly, very occasionally trying to de-rust a little bit, missing on aim on a 4-star, I feel that.
Yeah. Well, you know, we've had two reading maps and two wins on two reading maps for Hippo Cup What. If they were picking according to the, you know, match and how things are going, I feel like we'd probably see another reading map, maybe something AR9. But they are picking Opacha.
You know, there's never a wrong time to pick Opacha.
Yeah, I respect it.
There's literally never a wrong time to pick Opacha. It's the song of all time. The map is like the map is just kind of funny. Like it's like here's some weird flow aim, but here's also these like strange like triplet things. It's
the shitty sliders that just look like they're old and not very well done in the map. Like, I don't know, that's great.
How old is this? What's the
2015? Last updated 2018.
What was this in? Like, this was like Dada had this somewhere, like back
Kitty.
In the day. I feel like I remember this being a Dada map, but I don't know exactly. I don't remember why I remember this being a Dada map. Somebody go find him now that he doesn't actually play Hippo Cup anymore, or tournaments in general anymore.
I love reading the comments on maps like this. You just scroll down and there's some person saying, the best map, :D, and then a reply that says lol, and then a reply from the original dude that says lel, with a capital L and an exclamation point at the end, 5 years ago.
Yeah.
I love looking at comments on maps like this. It's
5 years ago. Also, one of the replies is lel.
Yeah,
and I don't think
lel.
I've seen someone say lel literally since like 2017.
Exactly. That's what makes it so funny. Scrolling
probably
through
the
this, like.
Okay, wait. Cookie.
It's a time capsule.
Cookiezy, Shigatora, Nathan on Rustbell, Nathan on Osu, Chocomint, 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 and then one reply.
An Osu player.
God. Oh my God. I love map comments for funny maps, dude.
This is something.
All right. So yesterday, Scroll FC'd this. We'll see if somebody can do that again here. I suppose this is ostensibly a bit easier in a way than Distant Snap, since it's not, or it's different, but like it's more straightforward.
It's not AR6.
Exactly.
So there's that.
All right, Ninrik, no. He breaks. LeGrand Ballner has basically their first lead of the match. Oh, there goes Ethan Trix and Z9A. Okay, it's trades. It's Tradesville. They're tradesmen. Who's your... like, which guy in the background do you identify with the most?
Gotta be the dude in the very background, like the heavy set guy with the jacket just chilling there in the back, like not even one of the three guys in front.
Not one of the main three.
No.
Oh, it's a late miss from Manny Vat. Wait a second. Eternum has a combo and he's gonna bring this back if he holds.
There it is.
Yep, Eternum carries these. He's got an FC with like 100 or 200s. Uh-oh. Well, Grand Ballner, you had such a good opportunity here, guys. Oh, Invoker just note-locked to hell on that circle stream, too. All right, well done, Eternum.
Yeah.
And they just
well,
went
you know, Eternum originally Russian, actually, so maybe just the buff on Opacha.
Wait, actually?
Yeah.
Why did I not know that?
He's lived in Romania for a long time.
Yeah, that's all I knew is he's been in Romania as long as I've known of him. So
yeah, but I know at one point was Russian, like a very long time ago. Doesn't even like talk to the Russian community all that much anymore. And talks way more to the Romanians, obviously. But yeah, he got the buff.
Are there any Russians in this match? There's Suzuha, who isn't maybe here today. The only one. The only person on the Grand Volner who could have gotten the buff is not here.
Simply a difference in genetics. Built different.
All right, that's a quick 4-0. So I'm just thinking, last match went 6-4 and it took almost an hour and a half. This one's at 4-0 in 20 minutes.
The duality of man.
The duality of man. All right, Grand Volner, you guys just got to mix it up here. Like, this has got to be like a tech pick or something. Just go completely different, because obviously, like, what's gone on so far has not been working so well.
Yeah, let's get some Nothing But Theory or some Idol or something. I don't know.
Nothing But Theory, man. That takes me back. What was it, like 2018, 2019, when you used to see that in every tournament? But it was that different the other div.
It was the Azerite one. Or no. It was the other one. It was the Irrationality diff or something like that.
No, the other one's Impractical Application, but I remember seeing Ultra Jazz function a bunch too.
Yeah. Or no. There's another set. There's another set of this. Set. Like Irrationality 2.0 or something like that is the diff name.
Oh my, they... Okay, well, we're getting what we
Easy.
Asked for.
Easy.
Easy, yo.
Easy every Next. Time.
You know what needed to be in this pool? If you're going to have Nothing But Theory, I feel like you also need to have... hang on. It's the Xerius map.
That doesn't narrow it down.
I know. I'm
you have thinking... any idea how little that narrows it down?
Hang on. I'll come up with it. Don't worry. It's just another one of those maps that was around in like all those tournaments back in that era. Where you in like 2018, 2019, you would just see it nonstop.
Was it like the Muke Jazz song, or was it?
Hang on.
One?
I will find Dizzy. Dizzy.
Dizzy? That I don't think I know that one, actually.
Alright. Yeah, yeah, yeah. By Baldwin and Wolfgang Lore.
Yes.
I will put it in our stream channel, and you will see what I'm talking about, and I feel like you should probably remember it. It's like...
Okay, yeah, Baldwin, I do know this.
Hollow Wings inspo. And it's just... It used to be in so many tournaments. Like, all of them.
Yeah, I do know this map, just vaguely. Yeah. Not super well.
It's a banger. Probably has been in a Hippocup before, to be honest. Actually, I could check that, but I have a master Hippocup sample spreadsheet somewhere. Hippo... map. Anyway,
well, in the meantime...
we're going to get some tech. They listen to us. I love it when they listen to us.
Same. Fragrance of Page, Ethan Trix, Eternum, Lucrece, Polly, Semi, Hanori, and Chillington.
Chillington. And somebody left.
Oh, goodbye,
somebody
Polly.
Somebody died. All right, so we were probably going to be getting a quick little abort. I don't know what happened, but somebody died. Dizzy was in Hippocup 2 in the finals Nomad Pool. Hippocup 2 would have been 2019, so that lines up.
Makes sense.
Also, that is that's like the cheating thing, right? When you abort at the very start of the map.
Yeah, it is.
I remember that tactic.
Remember that, actually.
That tactic was so funny.
Yeah, you would like
you'd like
abort
ask for
at the
abort.
Very start to load in a replay or something.
Yeah.
If you were replay submitting, that's how it went.
All right, in we go. First time probably a lot of people have seen Nothing But Theory in quite some time. This is it's just a cool tech map. I'm a fan. Tech alt? Alt tech? Alt tech, I suppose, is probably the alt first, tech second.
Yeah. I don't think we have to worry about that with Polly, though. Missed already twice in the map.
No, I should say, I'm obviously not actually accusing him of cheating, by the way. It's just that's just what that made me think of when he used to get aborts at the very beginning of maps. I am in no way accusing him of anything.
Yeah.
I don't feel like I should have to make that clear, but I'm going to just in case. Ethan Trix also with an early break, so 3 FCs against 3.
Or 2 FCs against 3,
sorry,
actually. Eternum also broke.
Yeah.
There's 2 for 2 now.
Yep, alright. So we've got Hanori and Manny against Fragrance of Page. That's quite the name. And Lucrece. I will never get over the name Fragrance of Page. Like, is that like how a book, like a book page?
It's that new book smell, you know?
Yeah, like, I love new book smell.
It's that new old book smell. Like, old book smell and new book smell are two very different things. But
yeah.
There's certainly some kind of fragrance to them. That's for sure.
You go to like a used bookstore and you just like open up some like ancient tome and it's that like musty sort of old smell to it. I know exactly what that. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, there goes Chillington and Polly, and now it's just Nori with the full combo on the Grand Balner and Fragrance Smell of Book, and Lucrece holding onto the full combos. There goes Smell of Book.
He's gone.
And now it's Ethan Trix and Lucrece with pretty big combos. Semi drops the corresponding combo for Ethan Trix, and now big combo lead for Hippocup Wet, as Eternum is also on 800 combo actually.
Yeah, he broke at the start and has been doing well since then.
And there goes Nori.
There goes Nori. All right, well, 5-0. Will we see? No, we won't. Lucrece with the break. No FCs here. Those are some very solid scores in general for Hippocup What. Got Lucrece on, I think, the 3-miss on that one last like horizontal stream pattern. Eternum, Ethan Trix with an S rank, actually. Like slightly lower combo than the others, unfortunately. Book smell of book, smell of book,
stench of library.
please, aroma of library. Let's not
aroma of library. Aroma of library. Bad. That's true. Aroma is a better synonym for fragrance.
Stench is a very negative connotation. We want to stay positive here today.
That's true.
That's what we're about here at Hippocup. We're all about the positivity. You just can't
perfume of tome.
Oh god. Jesus. Right. This guy's on fucking like Rhyme Zone, or not Rhyme Zone, on thesaurus.com.
Right? I'm literally not. I'm just like thinking of more terms I can use.
Scent of paper. I like that from Twitch chat. That's a pretty good one.
Oh. Oh my god. Anyway, right. DT2.
We're gonna do something really boring. We're just gonna pick DT2, man. How, like, you go like Opa-cha into nothing but theory, and then you just pick Revolutionary Etude. Like, man, come on.
This match has had like a bunch of really funny maps in a row. Like, we did Kirby Mix to start, Uro Omote Lovers with perfect stack streams, Promise, Opa-cha, and then nothing but theory, and now we get just the most normal map in the pool.
It's just like, here's the Nomad 2, guys. Like, we're just gonna play the boring. Like, how many alternatives did they have here? Like, there's like Hollywood Galaxy Nomad 2. There's Idol Nomad 4.
Sound Paradise.
Paradise Nomad 6, right? Like, there's so many. All the entire Hard Rock pool, which, I mean, Chat Perdu and Terminal and Sakura's Fall, like, man. Or they could have even picked Ice Cream Cake, bro. I need my K-pop in the morning. Where's my K-pop in the morning? Unbelievable.
Is it a red velvet ice cream cake?
It is. Yeah. It is indeed. Red velvet ice cream cake. That sounds pretty tasty, actually. I do like ice cream cake, and so that would be a high quality ice cream cake. Although I don't know about ice cream cake for breakfast is the only problem. Well, actually, it's 11:30. I guess we're like getting onward into where it would feel more appropriate in the day.
Yeah. So
I'm getting pinged up here for. Hang on.
Well, DT2, it is time. 218 BPM DT alt, I think. Louis Cipher diff of this map. Fire Rage, Nenaric, Eternum, Lucrece for Hippocup Wet. Invoker, Z9A, Hifkill, and Chillington 15, also known as Manivot, for Le Grand Balner. Everyone has their no-fail on this time around, so no early aborts.
Hello.
Hello.
And the client is trying to get us into the map, and Hifkill is dead? Hifkill is not dead. There we go.
Wait, Fiery Rage.
Fiery Rage.
Will they win this? Nenaric breaking early. Fiery Rage in for a tapping map. Will they win it anyway? The answer to that so far is yes, with Lucrece and Eternum doing Lucrece and Eternum things. OWC teammates together here. Oh, wait, there goes Eternum. You've got Manny on the combo, on the FC, Hifkill on the combo, Z9 and the combo as well, and it's gonna be... Maybe. Wait, Daniel broke. Wait.
Oh, just barely.
Not enough. Not enough.
Not enough.
Despite the best efforts of Lucrece, a 100k win, Logran Balner is on the board by 152,000 points. Semi says, what's with the BM? You're up 5-0 and you put Fiery in for DT2. I guess I can see where they're coming from. We didn't have an HD player, but like...
Sure, but you know, just throw in Aurora of Papyrus and suddenly I think you're doing a lot better for yourselves on the side of Hippocampus.
Yeah, I get where Semi's coming from here. I'm not sure I am fully behind that. I mean, I don't know that it was like... I mean, they lost, so like it backfired on them. They should have probably won that map. But also, like, if Eternum FCs, they win the map, or if Ninerik doesn't 7-miss, they win the map. So, I mean, yeah, I don't know. It's
yeah, a little, whatever.
Whatever. Stuff happens. All right. Well, Grand Balder now gets another pick.
I mean, hey, we were discussing that picking the normal map when we were on 5 funny maps in a row is a troll. So, you know what? They get what's coming to them. They get what's coming to them.
So true. So true. And that gives LeGrand Balner the opportunity to pick Ice Cream Cake.
That's true.
So really, who's the real winners here? It's all of us. It's all of us. Or Idol, just because I really like that song. Okay, hey, there you go.
they were discussing in chat earlier for Hippocup what that they hated the Nomad 4, so now LeGrand Balner will pick Nomad 4.
Yep, I mean, you know, we do a small amount of shithousing, perhaps.
Yeah.
Again, like, if you're going to talk about maps that you hate, don't be surprised when the other team picks them. That's kind of how it goes.
Yeah. This set's actually ranked by Ancient.
Ancient?
Yeah, it's just pronounced Ancient,
Anxiant.
Anxiant. Anxiant, a mapper who, I mean, this is ex-Lollycore's diff, yeah, you know, whatever. Anxiant, a mapper who stopped mapping for Sirius for a little while there, but came back in 2022, 2023 and started... mapping a bunch of stuff, actually. Has been ranking some sets like Catch the Glory from Catch World Cup 2022, I want to say. Maybe 2023. I think 2023.
My knowledge of Catch World Cups is non-existent, so your guess is way better than mine on that one. Minigames.
Call it 2023.
Minigames. Yo, this could just be the Tim Henson cover, and that would be pretty cool.
The Tim Henson cover of this? What?
Yeah, I'll go get it for you.
That is something.
I'll go get it for you. Tim Henson Idol. It's not a full version. It's only like a minute. It's like the actual OP version. I'm gonna put it in Twitch chat so that they can enjoy it as well.
Let's go.
I mean, it's Tim Henson, like, if you know it's gonna be good. He shreds. Alright, in we go. See if Hippocampus can close this out with a breakpoint on their second match point here, or if Grand Balner can put another one on the board. I mean, probably Hifkill, Manny Vat, pretty strong on this, I feel, but I mean, Fiery Rank, I hope. I'm running out of synonyms or fragrance of page, I'm sorry.
I think we may have exhausted most of them.
Yeah. Silly Ethan, tricks are for kids. Polly, first break in the slow section before the Ki, not ideal. Not ideal. In we go, first Ki. Banger. Hifkill next to break.
Yeah, instantly Hifkill breaks, instantly Semi breaks, and now it's 4 full combos to 1 in favor of Hippocampus. Yeah, solid start for HippoCup What on this map, despite talking about how much they hate it in the lobby chat. Maybe it was all a ruse. It's all an elaborate plot.
Their scheming has gotten them maybe a win. Manybat is in fact chilling though. Like, he's down there in the bottom right corner, hanging out, staying in his own lane, moisturized, hydrated, thriving.
What does that say about HippoCup What? Do they have a you know, a beauty team backstage for them? I think Raikaho missed his appointment this morning.
They're actually all employees of Sephora, little did you know.
My God. Hey, Sephora doesn't sell moisturizer. That's the wrong brand.
I'm pretty sure Sephora sells everything skincare you could possibly imagine.
Also,
they just triple broke. It is now just Fiery Rage.
Yeah, they missed the beauty team this morning.
Fortunately, LeGrand Balmer has also full reset in the last 200 combos, so it does not matter. Yo, any 1/3 enjoyers? Or this is a tempo change, actually. I don't know.
This is 1/3, I believe.
Yeah. Semi, no! Ethan, no! Alright, Fiery is, this is the duality of Fiery. He has to go in for DT2 and does as you'd expect Fiery to do in DT2, but then he gets to come in for Nomad 4 and just, like, crushes it.
Yeah.
I remember, I don't know, like, Fiery on tech maps, like, especially anything before, like, Grand Finals, like, he's just gonna pop off, I feel.
Yeah.
On, like, any Nomad 3, Nomad 4 type stuff, he's super, super consistent.
This is, like, kind of a mix, but still mostly alt. I also want to, just a slight aside, anime openings. There are precisely two types of anime opening songs ever in the entire industry. They are 180 to 220 BPM jump maps or jump songs with lots of half beat stuff.
And then there are... The alternative.
The alternative is alt.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Yeah, and they're either 130 BPM or they're 180 BPM, and like
yeah.
It is interesting how that works out. Also, Fiery is pulling the FC into the ending. Will he get it? Yes, he will. Well done, Mr. Rage. That is a nice score from HippoCup What as well.
Fiery, yeah, nicely played.
Nearly 1v4. Well, not really. 30 mil versus 37, but still. Yeah. HippoCup What? 6-1 victors. GG's. Well done to them. They made that look, I don't want to say easy, but they made that look pretty easy. 6-1 is a very straightforward sort of affair. Especially after we just had an hour and a half single match. This one taking 40 minutes. You can kind of, you know, see the difference in matchups here. And that sends them onward into quarterfinals. I don't actually know who they'll be playing. I can find that out. They'll be playing the winner of Let's Get K-Barbecue versus Pension, whatever. That match is... that's the next match. So we'll get to know who they're playing after the next match.
Very cool.
Poggers. But that's going to do it for the moment. We'll be back in 15 minutes or so for that match, as mentioned. There will be almost simultaneously, 1730 UTC. Left me broken. I don't know how that team is playing at 1730 UTC, but good luck to them against Costco Hot Dog, for whom that is a much more comfortable time. So those will be at 17 and 1730 UTC. Hope you are here for those. We'll be back for that. Thank you, Theo. Thank you, James. Thank you, Kay. Thank you, viewers. And congratulations to HippoCup What. We'll see them
thank
in the quarter.
Thank you, Aaron. And thank you, Habib. See you soon.
Goodbye for now. Shut up, sorry, neta mi shutto nante nai wake ga nai kore wa neta janai kara koso yurusenai